which end in F or FE. We form their plural forms by changing F or FE to V by adding ES. Like, we have thief, T-H-I-E-F. We will make this thief to plural form by removing F and adding V-E-S. Replace F by V and add ES. It becomes a plural, like thieves. See, the pronunciation is also different. Thief, thieves. And next, wife, wives. W-I-F-E, wife. Here, we are replacing F with V and we'll add ES. It becomes wives. W-I-V-E-S, wives. Similarly, knife, knives. F, elves. Here, you need to learn everything again. Then, the nouns dwarf, hoof, scarf and wolf take either S or V-E-S in their plural forms. See here, there are certain nouns which can either take S for formation of plural or either it can be formed by adding ES. Example, dwarf, dwarfs or dwarves. It's the same. The plural meaning gives the same, but you can add S or ES. But always remember, read the question and then answer to it. And other words ending in F or FE can be formed as plural nouns, like chief, chiefs. We'll add S here. We'll not replace F with V. Directly add S and make it as a plural. Then gulf, gulfs, and so on. Read this again and learn it. Then a few nouns form their plural by changing the inside vowel of the singular. So here, words which have vowels in them, five vowels, A, E, I, O, U. So if there is a vowel in a noun, we will replace the vowel. For example, man, men, M-A-N, man. Vowel in man is A, and when you change it to plural, the vowel A will be replaced by the other one, E, men. Similarly, woman, women. Then foot, feet, tooth, teeth. See, the vowels are only getting replaced. There is no addition of word, letters in the beginning or at the end. Only the vowels are getting replaced. Goose, geese, mouse, mice, louse, lice. Clear? And then, there are a few nouns that form their plural by adding en to the singular. For example, ox, oxen, child, children. Clear? We'll not tell childs. The plural form is children. Ox, oxen, and so on. Then, the plural of fish is fish or fishes. In current English, fish is the usual plural. Fishes can be used to refer to different kinds of fishes. Fish, for example, if you're talking about fish, even the plural form of fish, 10 fishes, you'll not tell 10 fishes, 10 fish. There were 10 fish in the aquarium. If you're talking about different kinds, for example, if you're talking about in your aquarium, if you have goldfish, zebra fish or tiger fish, you will tell these different kinds of fish as fishes. But if you're just having 3-4 sucker fish in your aquarium, you will tell I have 4 sucker fish. Understanding the difference, one type of fish, if it is even in 100 in number, you'll tell fish only. But if there are different types, you will tell fishes. Clear? And then we have some nouns that have the singular and plural alike. So there are certain nouns which have singular form also the same and plural form also the same. Like pair. Pair is how many number? 2. Dozen? 12. And then score, gross, 100, 1000. When used after numerals. So we use these numbers after certain numbers. If you buy 2 pair of shoes, you'll just tell 2 pair of shoes, you'll not tell 2 pairs of shoes. Because we are already telling a pair has two things. And you're talking about how many pairs you brought. So again, you'll tell I have 2 pair of shoes. Then again, you'll tell dozen. We buy eggs in dozen, right? So I'll tell 2 dozen of eggs. Clear? Similarly, we have other words like 100, 1000. Then we have cod, trout, aircraft, spacecraft, series, species, and so on. You need to read this and learn again. For example, I bought 3 dozen oranges. See here, the number 3 And dozen is again a plural form because it has 12 in number, but we are not changing it to again other plurals by adding s or yes something. It remains the same. Then again, the sari cost me 5,000 rupees. Am I telling 5,000s? No, I'm just telling 5,000 rupees. So 1,000 remains the same. Similarly, you have other examples. You need to read it by yourself. And then some nouns are used only in the plurals. There are certain words which are used only in plural forms. For example, names of instruments which have two parts forming a kind of pair, like bellows, scissors, tongs, pincers, spectacles. So now there are things which are to be told only in plural form. You will not tell spectacle for your spectacles. You will tell spectacles because it has a pair in it. Again, when you're talking about scissors, you will tell it, give me a pair of scissors. You'll not tell, give me scissor, yeah. That's the wrong way. And again, when you're talking about names of certain articles of dress, like trousers means pants, then drawers, breeches, jeans, tights, shorts, and so on. Again, other nouns like annals, thanks, proceeds, etc. Then some nouns originally singular are now generally used in plurals, like arms, riches, eaves. Riches do many things. There are certain words, when you read it, it sounds like they are plural, but in nature, they are singular, like mathematics, it's a singular again, physics, it's a single subject, electronics, again a single subject, and so on. The word news, it's a singular again, it's not plural. Then names of some common diseases like measles, mumps, rickets, and so on. Again, name of some games like billiards, draughts, and so on. I'm sorry, it's billiards. Clear? Then we have the collective nouns. Though they are singular in form, we always use it in plurals like these poultry are mine, whose are these cattle, and so on. You need to read this and learn it. Then we have a compound noun generally forms with plural by adding s to the principal word. Compound nouns are two nouns or two or more words which form one noun. For example, commander and chief. The commander is the principal main word here. If I have to make this as plural, I will add s to commander and it becomes commanders in chief. Similarly, son-in-law, sons-in-law. You'll not tell son-in-laws, you'll tell sons-in-law. Like this, you have other words, you need to read it by yourself. Again, many nouns taken from foreign languages keep their original plural form as erratum, errata, formula, formulae, or you can even tell it as formulas, radius, radii. So these are foreign words, clear? And from Greek you have axis, we'll tell it as axis, crisis, crisis, basis, basis, and so on. You need to learn this again. So similarly, we have it in Italian, French, and Hebrew languages. You need to read it and learn it. And then we have some nouns have two forms of the plural, each with somewhat different meaning. So some nouns have different plural forms with different meanings. Brother, brothers, sons of the same parent. Cloth, cloths, kinds of pieces of cloth. Again, die, dies, stamps for coining. So here, in the word singular brother, there are two different plurals. One, brothers, and or you can tell it as sons of the same parent. Brothers means sons of same parent. And you can even tell it as brethren, which is called as members of society or a community. So clear with two different forms. Similarly, you have other words you need to read and learn. Then there are other nouns. First one, light. You can tell light as radiance or light from a lamp. So lights, lamps, plural form. People, nation. People means it can be a nation. Other meaning is men and women. So plural form is peoples and nations. Hence you need to learn the other words. Last, you have color. Singular form of color is hue. And other word for color is hue. It's a singular form. And for plural, colors, you can also tell it as hues or the flag of a regiment, and so on. You need to read this and learn again. There are certain nouns which have different meanings when it comes to singular form, and meaning changes when it is in the plural form. Example, air, In singular, it is atmosphere, but in plural, airs. It is called as affected manners. And then good, it is benefit or well-being. Goods is merchandise, that is goods, things. So here, this is what we understand in this box, that when the word is in singular form, it has a different meaning. When it is in plural form, it has a different meaning. So similarly, you need to learn everything. The more you read, the more you improve your communication skills. To improve your communication skill, what you have to do? You need to keep reading again and again. That will bring good practice when you're talking to somebody. Clear? So quickly brush up. See, we make the singular nouns to plural most of the times by adding S. And if the words are ending with Y, we will replace Y with IES. And if the word ends with CH, S, SH, X or Z, we make it a plural form by adding ES again. And if the words are ending with F or FE, we will remove the F and we'll replace it as VES. And if it is a noun, if it is a vowel, we will replace the vowel with other vowel. For example, man, men. Clear? So here, you need to learn all the noun numbers and practice once. Clear? Thank you.